Hey there, I am documenting my third and last TCA spot treatment peel for a while. So this is going to be my third one in a row, and it's recommended that you kind of space them out every 3 weeks and only do three in a row, and then give your skin a break for 3 to 6 months. So I thought I'd document my last one. And what I've been using is Makeup Artist Choice, and this is 18% trichloroacetic acid peel that they have available. So I'm going to be taking care of my hyperpigmentation and three spots specifically. So they're here, so you can see them. Sorry about the lighting in here. This is a really small bathroom, and right now you're seeing my reflection in the medicine cabinet mirror. So it was a really tricky setup, but you know, I just wanted to do this and be over a sink. So you know, just wanted to be safe there. But what I have with me, my supplies, I always bring my TCA brochures with me in the bathroom, so I have it for reference anytime I need it, in case, you know, I have a brain fart and it's like, oh my gosh, like how long am I supposed to leave it on? Then I have everything, I reread it to make sure I'm doing the right thing. So I have my brochure with me and keep it next to me. I also have my cotton balls, cotton pads, and cotton swabs for application of the acid itself and to neutralize. My neutralizer is, I'm just using a pre-mixed one. This is from Exuviance by Neostrata. It's the same thing. There's the baking soda in here, so it's just easier for me to just spray it on the pad and to neutralize. I also have a timer. And this is just from the dollar store, but it's very helpful because you don't want to lose track of time. TCA works really quickly, and you just don't want to get caught with having it on your skin too long if you get distracted or something. So I always set my timer. In my little bucket, I have my acids here. So besides my 18% trichloroacetic acid, I have my other things that I use. There's the 12.5% TCA, which I started off using, and I did my three treatments of that. I also have 55% lactic acid, also 25% mandelic acid, and the pH prep solution. So I have just a little bit left of it, but I've been actually using witch hazel instead. So I've already prepped my face with the cleansing gel. It's the green tea pomegranate cleansing gel from Makeup Artist Choice. And prior to this, they had the green tea cleansing bar. It's now discontinued, so I was using that for a while, but this smells so much nicer. It lathers up and rinses off very well, and so I'll be using this one instead. We'll just dump out the cleansing bar, what I have left, and instead of that pH prep solution, I've been just using regular witch hazel. So I already put some on there. Okay, so I'm actually ready. I start off with using a Q-tip for application because it's such a small area, and you just don't want to use too much on it. You don't want the Q-tip to be sopping wet, because if it does, it kind of pools at the bottom of the spot, and then it's an uneven peel. So learn the hard way. So right now, I have my 18% TCA. I'm just going to open it up and just dip a little in here. So just make sure it's just not sopping wet, so I kind of roll the edge on the side. And so I don't knock it over or anything, I always close it up. I'm, you know, safety first. Okay, so I'm going to start. I'm just going to apply it to the spot itself. This might get boring for you, but just want to make sure. Get that done. So these two here are actually sunspots. This one is from a pimple. So you can see it's actually working better on my acne scar than not. And I'm also going to do this one. This one is a acne spot as well. And actually it's half the size as it used to be. You might as well, since my Q-tip is still wet, I'll just go for these guys. So I don't mind my freckles, but these spots are really annoying. I'm leaving this one alone here because it's so close to my eye. So I'm just watching here. And you can actually see it frosting. So I didn't set my timer because the 18% moves so quickly. So it's already frosting, if you can see that. It's already turning white, and it's already kind of tingling. So spraying my cotton pad with some solution. So you see it frosting already, and this is where you kind of want to start to neutralize. So I just hold it on here and just let it kind of saturate in. So these aren't really frosting yet. So I'll just leave that on a little longer. But see how quickly the 18% moved? So as far as Asian skin, they recommend nothing higher than 20% because Asian skin is very, very delicate and sensitive and would tend to scar more after a treatment. There. So I'm just going to neutralize the rest. So very quick, huh? So from there, I want to make sure that I got everything off. Then I will wash, I will cleanse again. I'm going to wash my face and then I'll get back to you, okay? Alright, thanks. Okay, I'm back and I just washed the solution off and the neutralizer. Just want to pat your face dry. So it's still a little white and it's going to turn red. So it's like kind of like wet all over. It's like splashing around like a little seal or something, or duck. Okay, so right now I'm going to add my antibiotic ointment to the mix. And I just take a little Q-tip and dab some on. And we want to make sure that we keep our treated areas moist, and that so it heals properly. Just kind of add some on there. There we go. So I'll be doing this for 2 days. And when I do my regular skincare, then I kind of just avoid the area. That's the good thing about spot treatments, that you don't have to mess up with the rest of, you know, the rest of your skincare routine. So, apply there. Yeah, that one's good. So like I said, this is a sunspot. This is a sunspot. There are lentigines, and that's caused by the sun's rays, and it's just kind of a sun damage. And this one was a scar from a pimple, as well as this one. So it seems to me that these are actually kind of breaking down, so you can actually see the spot kind of breaking apart. So there's actually normal colored skin underneath or coming through. So this one's half the size that it used to be. It's a little, it's still there, but the top part is kind of faded. And then there's like the darker area. So, okay. So that's my TCA spot treatment.